Hello everyone, in this video we have one square, two semicircle, and these are given as tangent points, point M and point N. These are given as center of the semicircle, point E and point H. These are given as midpoints, and radius of the small semicircle is given 6 units. So the question is, what is the area of the yellow shaded region? Okay, first step, note that if radius is 6, that means this length is also 6, right, because of radius. So we know that here is 45 degrees, because triangle EDH is an isosceles right triangle, so here is also 45 degrees. Next step, if there's a 12 units opposite of the 90 degrees, opposite of the 45 degrees must be equal 6 root 2, right? So here is 6 root 2, and here is 6 root 2, and also here is 6 root 2. After that, if we connect these three points like this, if you notice that point F becomes the middle point, right? Next step, here is also 45 degrees, right? And if you draw a perpendicular line from the center onto the chord, like this, the chord will be divided into two equal parts, right? And if there's a 6 units opposite of the 90 degrees, opposite of the 45 degrees must be equal 3 root 2. And this part is also 3 root 2, and this part is 3 root 2 as well. After that, if you focus on triangle MBF, here is 90 degrees, right? And this length is 6 root 2 because of radius. Then, if we connect these points like this, notice that these are equal because of radius, right? And these are also equal because of radius. That means we get a kite. So MFGN is a kite, right? Therefore, we know that in every kite, if we connect vertices like this, we get an angle bisector line, right? Well, the area of triangle MBF is equal 6 root 2 times 6 root 2 over 2, right? So the area equal 36 units squared. Okay. And then, if you focus on triangle FMG, this length is also 6 root 2, right? Because of radius. After that, let's call these two equal angles alpha. So here must be equal 90 minus 2 alpha, right? So if you focus on triangle MFG, notice that the area of the triangle MFG is equal, if you use sine formula, 6 root 2 times 6 root 2 over 2 times sine 2 alpha, right? You know that the expansion of sine 2 alpha equal 2 times sine alpha times cosine alpha. So sine alpha equal, if you focus on this triangle, let's draw here. Here is 3 root 2, and this length is 9 root 2. Note that ratio of these two sides equals 3. If the ratio of the sides is 3, then the hypotenuse is 10 times the square root of the smaller side. So the hypotenuse must be equal 3 root 20. Therefore, this length is 3 root 20. So, sine alpha equal 3 root 2 over 3 root 20. And cosine alpha equal 9 root 2 over 3 root 20. Right? Therefore, if you simplify the expression, these are again. So sine 2 alpha equal 2 times 3 times 2 over 20. So sine 2 alpha equal 3 over 5. Therefore, if you plug in this value to the equation, so the area of the triangle MFG is going to be 108 over 5. Right? Okay. Let's clear here. If you focus on this triangle, the area of this triangle equal 6 root 2 times 6 root 2 over 2 times sine 90 minus 2 alpha, right? Therefore, if you simplify the expression, these are again. So 36 times, you know that sine 90 minus 2 alpha equal cosine 2 alpha. So we had calculated sine 2 alpha as 3 over 5, right? If you draw the right triangle, which base angles equals 2 alpha, like this, if sine 2 alpha equal 3 over 5, that means this triangle is 3 over 5 spatial right triangle. That means cosine 2 alpha must be equal 4 over 5. Therefore, if you plug in this value to the equation, so the area of the triangle CMG is going to be 144 over 5. So the area of the yellow shaded region equal 36, we know that 36 equal 108 over 5 plus the area of this triangle 108 over 5, right? And the area of this triangle 144 over 5. That means the area of the yellow shaded region is going to be 432 over 5 units square. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye bye.